Hey friends, how are you all? My name is Arshit Devedi, friends, and I welcome you back to my video. So in this video, friends, I will be talking to you regarding this Physiographic Division of India. I will be giving a brief idea about them because this Physiographic Division consists of the Northern Mountains, which is actually the Himalayas, then the Northern Plains, then the Peninsular Plateau of India, then the Great Indian Desert, then the Coastal Regions, and then finally comes the Islands of India. So all of these things will be discussed by me, friends. I will give you a slight idea about all of these things. The detail will be given by me in a separate video. I will dedicate a separate video for all of these topics because they deserve a separate video. And for these Northern Mountains, that is the Himalayas, some 2 or 3 videos will be required. So I'll be making them accordingly. So this video is presented by me, Harshit Devedi, friends. If you want to follow me, the link of my Instagram profile is given in the description box below. Also, this video is in English, friends. If you want to watch the Hindi version of the video, the link of that is also given in the description box below. Now, this figure will give you about the geological configuration and the geological occurrence of these divisions. So the Northern Mountains is denoted by the brown region here. So this comes the Northern Mountains. Then this region I will not count because this is Nepal, friends. So this is out of our consideration. This is not our country. Then this region, brown. So this is also the Northern Mountains. So these are the Northern Mountains in the brown. Then comes the Northern Plain, friends. So this whole green region is the Northern Plain. It is also extending in the northeast. So this is primarily composed of alluvial soil. The next is the Thar Desert, friends. This Thar Desert is located by this light yellow. So this is present here. Then comes the Peninsular Plateau region. So this Peninsular Plateau region, friends, here, this is denoted by this orangish color. So this is the Peninsular Plateau region. This is basically triangular in shape. Then comes the Coastal Plains, friends. So coastal plains are found on both the eastern and western edges. This is the western edge coastal plain. This is the eastern edge coastal plain. And then comes the island. So there are 2 major island groups in India. One is the Andaman and Nicobar island groups, and the second is the Lakshadweep island groups. So all of these things I will be discussing, a brief idea about them I will be giving, friends, because the detail I cannot provide here. Detail can be covered in separate videos. So the Northern Mountains are actually the Himalayas, which are young fold mountains. So friends, fold mountains are out of many types. There are old fold mountains, there are young fold mountains. So Himalayas are young fold mountains. That is why they are so pointed and so high. An example of old fold mountains is the Aravallis. So Aravallis at one point of time in history would have been as high as Himalayas are today. But today Aravallis is short because a lot of erosion and weathering of Aravallis has taken place. But it is an old fold mountain. So this Himalayas spread in a distance of 2400 kilometers. The width varies from 400 kilometers in Kashmir to 160 kilometers in Arunachal Pradesh. Now, first of all, the very first type which I am going to talk to you is the Trans-Himalayas, friends. Trans-Himalayas are the Himalayas which are lying north to this Great Himalayan Range. Now, let us have a look at this Great Himalayan Range, friends. This is the Great Himalayan Range. This comes from here, it goes this complete. This Great Himalayan Range is written here. So north to this Great Himalayan Range comes Zaskar Range, Ladakh Range, Karakoram Range. So all of this comes under the Trans-Himalayas. Basically, the major portion of the Trans-Himalayas is located in the Tibet. So that is why it is also known as Tibetan Himalayas. And part of it are the Zaskar, K2 Goodwin Austin, the Ladakh Range, Kailash Range, Karakoram Range. So these are the main ranges of Trans-Himalayan system in India. Then you can see the order of these mountain ranges, friends. The uppermost is the Karakoram Range, then Ladakh, then Zaskar, then Pir Panjal Dhauradhar. So Pir Panjal Dhauradhar are not even in the Greater Himalayan Range, it is below to that. So about them I will be also talking later on, friends. Then moving forward, we are going to talk about the Great or Inner Himalayas. This Great Himalayan Range, I have already told you, it is also known as Inner Himalayas, it is also known as Himadri. So they have one of the highest peaks. The average height is 6000 meters, and many perennially slow bound and other important glaciers are present in this Greater Himalayas. They include the Kamet Range, Kanchenjunga Peak, Nanga Parbat Peak, Annapurna Peak, and the most known Mount Everest Peak, which is the highest, 8,848 meters above sea level. So all of these are present in the Great Himalayan Range. This Mount Everest comes in Nepal. Just keep that in mind, friends. Then the second thing is the Lesser Himalayas, which comes below the Great Himalayan Range. And below the Lesser Himalaya comes the Shivaliks. Then the Eastern Hills and Mountains. Now let us have a look at this image, friends. This is the Shivalik. Above this is Pir Panjal Dhauradhar. Okay, so in between this Great Himalayan Range and Shivalik Range comes the Middle Himalayas. Okay, then eastern Himalayas is going on the eastern edge of India, friends. So let us come to the initial figure. So what are the eastern Himalayas? Eastern Himalayas are these. Okay, in the northeast area, the Himalayas which are coming are the eastern Himalayas. So I will be talking about them to you in a separate video, friends. Then the next classification is Himalayas from west to east. There is a regional classification of Himalayas in which Punjab Himalayas, Kumaon Himalayas, Nepal Himalayas and Assam Himalayas come. So a separate video for this will be made by me, friends. Then coming on to the northern plains of India. So the northern plains of India comes to the south of the Himalayan system, friends. And they are found because of the interplay of three major river systems. And these major river systems will also consist of their tributaries. So these major river systems are Indus, Ganga and Brahmaputra. Along with their tributaries forms this northern plains. And this northern plains mainly comprises the alluvial soil. Alluvial soil has been deposited in these northern plains for millions of years, friends. And these Himalayan plains are also around 2400 kilometers long. Their width varies from 240 kilometers to 320 kilometers. There are three main sections: Punjab plain, Ganga plain and the Brahmaputra plain. So you can have a look at the figure of these, friends. This is the complete, you can say, northern plains, friends. So this is break up into two sections. First is the Punjab plain located here, second is the Ganga plain located here, and third is the Brahmaputra plain located here. Okay, so they are being separated because according to the width and according to the region through which they are passing, mainly comprised of alluvial soil. It is very, you can say, fertile area, but the fertility of this region is slowly decreasing because of unsustainable agricultural practices. However, the present government is trying to arrest those unsustainable agricultural practices. Let's see what's going to happen in future. Then the next thing which we are going to talk about is the desert, friends. Now, you know, the Aravali Hills are somewhere here in Rajasthan, stretching like this. Okay, so on the western edge of the Aravali Hills lies this Indian desert, this complete red region. This complete red region denotes the desert area, friends. Okay, it is bordering with the Pakistan. So the rainfall received in this region is less than 150 mm a year. So the rainfall is scanty. So the climate is very, very arid, and the vegetation is also scanty in this plate. The most prominent river of this region is Luni, and Luni also in the summer region, the Luni almost disappears, but in the rainy season, some streams of this river, Luni River, again appear. Then forward comes, friends, I will be talking about the Peninsular Plateau. As I have showed you in the starting, Peninsular Plateau is triangle in shape. It is surrounded by hills and it is surrounded by one of the oldest rocks. Now, why one of the oldest rocks? Because this Peninsular Plateau, how this is formed? See, friends, you know, I told you about the continent Pangaea. Pangaea broke up into two parts. It broke up into the Laurasian and then the Gondwana part. So the Laurasia and Gondwana. So this Indian plateau, this Indian plate break apart from the Gondwana plate, and then it started its movement towards the Eurasian plate. Now what happened, friends, that during that movement many rocks formed. So the rocks through which this Peninsular Plateau is made is one of the oldest in the history of this earth. Also, friends, the Deccan Trap, which is being formed, this is being formed because of the volcanic activity when this Indian plate was passing over the Reunion hotspot near the present day Madagascar. So this is one more important fact which I have covered in my previous videos. I'm just giving you an idea here, so don't get too much confused about it. When I will be discussing these individual topics, I will be telling each and everything again to you. So this plateau can be divided into two parts: Deccan Plateau and the Central Highlands. Now the Central Highlands is denoted by this. You can see it in this figure. And the Deccan Plateau comes here. What comes in the Central Highlands? Malwa Plateau, Bundelkhand, Baghelkhand and Chota Nagpur Plateau. In the Deccan Plateau comes the Deccan Trap, the Western Ghats, the Eastern Ghats, the North Extension. So Deccan Trap, I have told you in previous videos, just be patient. When I will be discussing this thing separately, I will again tell you about the Deccan Trap. Western Ghats is present here. Eastern Ghats on the eastern edge of the Indian subcontinent, and Northeast Extension is there, this region. Because this Northeast Extension is an extension of the Peninsular Plateau only. Actually, it was a part of a peninsular plate, but because of a fault in between, this got separated from the mainland. Okay. Then comes the coastal plains, friends. This is the Eastern Coastal Plain, Western Coastal Plain. So these coastal plains comes on the western side. Western Coastal Plains come in between the coast and the Western Ghats Mountains. And this Eastern Coastal Plains comes between the Eastern Ghats and the coast. So western ghats and coast, in between there are small amount of plains. Now these plains, no matter, are very very long, but they are very small in width. You can see this is the Kathiawar coast near the Gujarat. Then comes the Konkan coast on the border of Maharashtra, coast of Maharashtra. Then the Kannad coast on Karnataka. Then the Kanyakumari coast, and this is also known as Malabar coast. If we come to the eastern edge, upper side at Odisha is Utkal coast. Below comes the Andhra coast. Both of them combined is known as Northern Sirkars. And here comes the Coromandel coast on the coast of Tamil Nadu. So these are the coastal plains. On the eastern edge of our continent, friends, subcontinent, you can see that these coastal plains are extending to a greater length from the coast to inside, because there are a lot of gaps in the eastern ghats. So obviously these plains extend inside the subcontinent. So coastal plains in the eastern part of India are a bit more broader than the western coastal plains. This I will be discussing separately, friends, when I will be doing a separate video on this. And when we talk about the islands of India, total 247 islands are there, 204 in Bay of Bengal, 43 in Arabian Sea. There are few coral islands also found in Gulf of Mannar. Okay. Then Andaman and Nicobar Islands in Bay of Bengal, they contain hard volcanic rocks. The Middle Andaman and the Nicobar Islands, they are the largest islands of India. Lakshadweep Islands in the Arabian Sea, they are formed of corals. So this was the basic information about islands, friends. The detail I will be telling in separate videos. I know, friends, I am a bit fast here, but actually the point is that I don't want to go too much deep into it here, because then the video will be very very long. I sincerely try to shorten the video, because long videos will be watched by very few people. There are very few enthusiastic people. Most of the people watch the duration and the time of the videos. So that is why I'm trying to make it short. So I hope you like this video. If you liked it, subscribe to my channel, like this video, comments, and tell me how you like this video. Share this video with more and more of your friends, and keep studying.